Diving deeper into the Greeks, we encounter gamma, a key derivative of delta, which itself is one of the most dynamic option Greeks. Recall that delta predicts the change in an option's price with a $1 movement in the underlying asset. Gamma takes this a step further by measuring how delta itself changes as the underlying asset moves. It tells us about the rate of change in delta over time. For example, consider XYZ Corporation's stock rising by $1. A call option with a gamma of 0.20 would see its delta increase by 0.20, all else being equal. Conversely, a call option with a gamma of 0.08 would see an increase of 0.08 in its delta under the same conditions. Gamma operates within the same minus 1 to plus 1 range as delta. Its role is pivotal in pushing delta towards either 0 or 1, representing an option with no intrinsic value, delta of 0, or 1 that moves dollar for dollar with the underlying asset, delta of 1. Both long calls and puts have positive gamma, while short calls and puts have negative gamma. If delta is our destination, gamma is the acceleration towards that destination. As options move deeper into the money, reaching closer to delta values of 1 or minus 1, their exposure to delta changes in a positively convex manner. This convexity is especially desirable for those holding long positions in options, aiming for the contract's value to increase as significantly as possible. A higher gamma, therefore, suggests a steeper increase in the option's dollar value, benefiting option buyers but posing a risk to sellers. Gamma is centered, or at its highest, around at-the-money options, where the strike price closely aligns with the current stock price. Both deep out-of-the-money options and deep in-the-money options tend to have gammas near zero, reflecting their delta's proximity to its destination. For out-of-the-money options, this means a long journey ahead before acquiring any intrinsic value, mirroring a low acceleration due to gamma. Conversely, deep in-the-money options, already near a delta of 1, have little to no gamma as they effectively mirror the stock's movements. Gamma's insights extend beyond mere sensitivity to underlying movements. It's instrumental in strike selection and strategizing around options. A higher gamma accelerates delta's journey to its destination, benefiting option buyers while being less favorable for sellers. Consider a bull call spread as an example, with XYZ Corporation at $100 per share. Buying one XYZ call option with a 100 strike price and a gamma of 0.04. Selling one XYZ call option with a 110 strike price and a gamma of negative 0.02. Recall that gamma is centered around at-the-money options. This means that upon initiating this strategy, the long call with the 100 strike will have the highest gamma, as it is at-the-money. Additionally, the higher gamma of the long call, being closer to the money, signifies that upward momentum favors the trade. As XYZ's price ascends past the 110 strike, the short call's gamma increases as the short 110 is now closer to the current stock price. This indicates that the strategy's maximum profit potential has been reached. Beyond this point, gamma turns negative, highlighting a risk zone where additional sharp movements in the underlying could render the strategy unprofitable. In essence, while delta maps the option's trajectory, gamma accelerates it. This acceleration is advantageous for long positions, but can be detrimental for short ones, thus playing a crucial role in strategy selection and optimization. Visit BMO.com/online investing to get started.